Started. All right, ladies and gentlemen, making his way to the blue corner from Dallas, Texas, representing San Antonio, Texas, introducing Richard Sugar Ray Howell.
Richard Ray Howell making his ring walk, fighting out of Texas. And actually did live some time in Southern California. Grew up right next to Jordan High School. Richard just loving this right now. He's been so happy all fight week. Just on cloud nine, such good energy. Made weight super easy this time.
All right, making his ring walk to the red corner from Caguas, Puerto Rico, introducing Angel Lopez.
I need all my Latinas on their feet right now. I need all my Latinas on their feet right now. Donde la gente latina en la casa? Donde la gente de México, de Chile, de Puerto Rico, los latinos, que nos vamos arriba, nos fuimos.
And JB Sports, powered by Koa Combat, and live on pay-per-view on Viva Live TV's Fight Night channel.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, this contest is scheduled for 4 3-minute rounds of boxing in the super lightweight division. This is brought to you by Koa Combat and Viva Live TV and the Fight Night channel. Your judges for this contest are Damian Walton, Don DeVerges, and Ray Corona. And the third man in the ring is referee Ivan Guillermo. Fighting to my right, out of the blue corner, from Dallas, Texas, representing San Antonio, Texas, standing at 5'9", he weighs 139.5 pounds, introducing Richard Sugar Ray Howell. Fighting to my left, out of the red corner, from Caguas, Puerto Rico, standing at 5'8", weighing in at 139 pounds even. He has a professional record of 6 wins, 3 losses, and 6 big wins by the way of knockout. Introducing Angel Lopez.
El gallito de Puerto Rico aquí gozando con nosotros. Shout out to all my people in Puerto Rico on the tune in. All my people that have gone out to get this fight for Angel Lopez. Team La Familia on the check-in. Jose Solis, El Gato Guerra, que están en el tune in. Saludito, muchacho.
I know Ray over here is just hyped for this fight.
I've been waiting for this, man. I've been waiting for this for over a year. We've been waiting to get Mamito back in the ring. And
this is a tough fight.
Yep.
Richard Ray coming off a win. Underrated record, too.
He's put some great work in the gym.
Yeah.
So, showtime.
Both guys have been here all fight week working. And, again, the quintessential nice guys in the sport, yet they got the most heat at the weigh-in. Love to see it.
Starting off with a jab. Memo just feeling him out here. We We got Howell in the blue trunks, Lopez in the Puerto Rico printed trunks.
I wonder if Richard, with his height, with his reach, is going to try to stay on the outside a little bit more. Or because of Angel Lopez losing his last three fights by knockout, is Richard going to try to be more aggressive?
And come in and go straight for that, yes.
Right now, it looks like Richard's trying to get that jab established. Angel Lopez, though, quick combination right there. Just a little bit short there. Maybe throw some feints, get that jab working, work his way on the inside.
Working that distance, yeah, trying to measure out the stage.
Right hand misses by Richard. Right hand lands by Richard. Richard leaving his hands a little bit low for my taste. I'll be honest, I think he could get caught.
Angel hitting the body early, working that body early.
Like that. If his hand was just a little bit off place, that would have been a devastating shot from Angel Lopez.
It's them feeling out stages of the first round. They're still measuring each other out, checking each other's power.
And both guys have a lot to lose in this fight.
Yes.
You know, Richard is coming off a win.
For both of them, yes.
It is, absolutely. If Richard wins this fight, he has a 4-2-2 record, a winning record, two wins in a row. If Angel Lopez wins, he reverses and erases those three losses instantly. And he's back with that momentum.
So definitely important fight for both camps. Mm-hmm. Putting their work here on Legacy continues on Fight Night Channel via Viva Live TV.
And sponsored by Patty's Q Jewelry, Estancia's Mexican Cuisine, and JB Sports. Powered by Koa Combat.
And if you'd like to sponsor, don't forget you can call 407-490-1479. Hit us up for our upcoming events. We'll be back at it July 23rd here on Fight Night Channel.
Good left hand by Angel. Split the guard of Richard.
Angel putting good work in the first round. Both of them are.
Again, a little bit of a feel-out process. I think, again, like we said, both guys have so much to lose. I don't think either guy really wants to commit with everything right now. Understandable. Oh, good counter right hand there by Richard at the bell.
Great first round of work by both opponents.
And close round, too.
Yes, sir. Very hard to judge on that. And that's why we are not the judges and we leave it up to them, ladies and gentlemen. But like I said, you can go ahead and leave your comments on the chat. You can let us know who you're going for. Who do you think won the round? Who do you think is our sexiest ring girl of the night? Let us know right here. What song do you want to hear by the DJ? Let's get some interaction by our fans tonight on the Tune In on Viva Live TV Fight Night Channel. Again, we have a packed house tonight. Packed house, even with a couple of our main ticket sellers falling off on the card. You know, we said it yesterday, stay positive, it'll be a good turnout. And today the fight fans are coming in,
and
we have a packed night.
Two.
And like we posted, you know, same fight, new date for Christian Camacho, Alexis De Luna.
Unfinished business on July 23rd by Camacho and Luna. Fighting for the GBO Continental belt at 126 pounds.
Both guys will be
short.
Angel
is coming
shots.
Up short, yes. If he gets that timing and he can get that distance right, though. Angel has a 6-3 record, 6 with 6 knockouts and 3 with 3 knockouts. And all that tells me is that when he comes in ready to fight. And, you know, and when that happens, sometimes there's chances that you may get clipped. But definitely never fighting with fear, always with the gas on the pedal and ready to fight. Team La Familia is known for that back in Central Florida. We have some great fighters coming out of that camp, like I said before. Jose Solis, Juan Guerra, El Gato, and hopefully we'll have them fighting. Maybe on a Fight Night Channel card very soon.
One of them needs to commit to really win these rounds, make it definitive. Mm-hmm. This round's another very close round.
Yeah, one of them is going to have to get in the driver's seat and really take control of this
fight. Good right hand there by Richard. He needs to follow that up. Oh, good combination there by Angel Lopez.
Working him in the corner, yes, putting pressure on him now that he has him up against the ropes.
That left hand landed clean. Oh, good left hand again by Angel Lopez. A little bit of a headbutt there.
Shout out to Orlando Boxing Gym with the check-in with the pay-per-view. Thank you to everybody that has bought the pay-per-view and is tuned in with us, showing their support to the network and to the channel. We appreciate you, and we will continue to bring you some great fights here on the channel throughout the year and for years to come. He tried with the uppercut there.
Oh, good right hand there by Richard. Both guys are doing a good job of when the other starts getting momentum, just tie up, you know, reestablish. Oh, good right hand again. Richard finding a home for that. Angel smothering has worked just a little bit.
End of round two here in Ontario, California.
And another close round. I have no idea how the judges are going to see this.
All right, don't forget to get your knockout coin powered by KOACombat.com, which supports youth and amateur professional insurance retirement for combat sports athletes and fighters.
I'm bringing Paul Banky and Big Surge on the telecast soon. We also have Christian Camacho in the building to talk to him about his upcoming fight here in Ontario, California on July 23rd. Unfinished business between Camacho and DeLuna as we start round three here in Ontario, California.
We also have Carlos Castro in attendance as well, PBC fighter, and fellow stablemate of Eduardo Diaz and Alexis Alvarado. Another good right hand by Richard. Another good right hand by Richard. Maybe he's a little more comfortable now, willing to exchange.
And getting into the third round now.
Another good left hand by Angel. He's so good at that range, that mid-range where he has Richard against the ropes. He just needs to stay there, not smother his work.
Putting pressure, working him in, and keeping that distance once he has him there, yes.
But not get too close, just like that. He got too close. Richard was able to tie up, disengage, reestablish distance. Good body work there by Angel.
Right off there.
Oh, another good right hand. Yes. The best shots of the fight landed in this round by Richard. And Angel. Angel landed another good shot as well. Another good right hand.
Came right back with his own combination.
Angel, though, is ducking right into that right hand.
Yes.
You can see it. He just needs to turn his shoulder, just slip the shot, and just roll out. Instead, he's ducking into the shot. Good shots by both. I think there's a little bit of headbutt there. Is Richard cut? Potentially. He's rubbing his head like
he's
he was cut.
Rubbing his head like he was cut. Yeah, definitely
but,
felt something.
There's another headbutt there. The ref should really warn them. Because it could ruin the fight for either guy. Headbutts are nasty. Come on, come on, come on.
needs to work his way out and create that distance again. There we go.
Good counter there by Angel.
He's been working that body now. See if it, you know, works in the later rounds.
Good slip there by Richard. Good counter. Oh, good. Good shots there by Richard. Richard might want to change his tactical, you know, plan here and really start being more aggressive. I think Angel doesn't handle that pressure that well. When Angel's allowed to sort of dictate the range, dictate the pace a little bit, he's able to find his shots. He's able to find his openings very well.
Pick them apart, yeah.
Yes.
Well, that's the fourth and final round.
First two rounds were a toss-up. I give the last round to Richard.
So this fourth round is very important in this fight. It could be the determining factor on who takes the victory tonight.
Remember, folks, Legacy Continued, brought to you by Red Promotions, Guerrero Promotions, and Ray Rock Entertainment. Sponsored by Patty's Q Jewelry, Estancia Mexican Cuisine, and JB Sports Tape. Powered by Koa Combat, and pay-per-view live on Viva Live TV's Fight Night channel. Fourth and final round. Can Richard keep up that success he had in the third round?
The pace that he had in the third round, yes. Or can Angel turn it around and take it into his favor?
Because the first two rounds could be scored for Angel, could be scored for Richard, could
this
be split.
This is where training camps come in, and you see who put that work to maybe bite down and take it to the fight.
Richard slipping the shot, doing the Blade Joe Saunders. Oh, good right counter there. May have buckled the leg there by Angel. Richard did a little catch and shoot there. I think he sensed it, too, because he came right at Angel after that break by the ref.
Not stand behind it. You got to really put pressure this round if he wants to take the round. Tried to counter there. Came up short.
Oh, another good counter there by Richard Howe. Oh, good jab there by Angel. Should have followed up with the left hand. Good left hand there by Angel. But again, smothering his work. He fell into Richard there.
Yes.
He just stayed on that mid-range. Richard is not comfortable on the ropes. But I do think a little bit of it's a concern there by both guys. They don't want to get caught with the counter because they have been caught with counters. And I think both guys have enough pop to really hurt the other here. Good counter there by Angel. Richard's mouth is wide open, breathing.
He needs to push back, create that distance, and follow it with a shot.
Oh, good. Good right hook there.
At the end, yes. He's putting the pressure. He's doing a great job of smothering him when he does.
I mean, better round for Angel Lopez. Good right hand there by Richard. I don't know if those single shots are going to be enough to win the round for Richard. Angel's put a little more consistent, a little more of a work output. Even though it hasn't been as efficient or effective, he's been the more busy worker.
We leave it up to our judges and take it to the scorecard between Lopez and Howell here.
I have no idea who's going to win this.
Yes, it's
no
a toss-up. Definitely a toss-up.
Arremangala la cuala, sí. Arremangala la cuala, no. Arremangala la cuala, sí.
I'll be back with you shortly on the telecast. Let me go up to the ring for the decision.
We'll be joined by Ray Rock later in the telecast. It's just me, Matthew Hunter, with Red Promotions and Mixed Combat Radio. Can Angel reverse the three-fight losing streak, or can Richard create the first winning streak in his career? Richard raising his arms, thinking he won. It's going to be tight. The judges could really see those first two rounds anyway. Even the third round was very close. I don't think the third round had a definitive winner, except for I slightly edged it towards Angel. Judges taking a little bit longer to get those scorecards in. I think showing how tough it was. Both guys raising their arms. Both guys think they won. Who do you think won the fight, ladies and gentlemen? Was it Richard edging it, or was it Angel Lopez? Here we go. Waiting for Robert James to get in the ring.
Ladies and gentlemen, after four rounds of boxing, we have a majority decision. We go to our scorecards. Judge Damian Walton scores the bout 40-36.
All four rounds.
Judge
going to
Don DeVerges scores the bout 38-38.
Draw.
Even, we have a draw. Judge Ray Corona scores the bout 39-37. Your winner by majority decision. Yellow the blue corner, Richard Sugar Ray Hall.
Wow, Richard Howe pulling off the upset. One judge gave him all four rounds. I don't know if I agree with that, but what a performance for Richard. He definitely had the more definitive round between the two in that third round, and definitely probably landed the more damaging shots throughout the fight. But what a close back and forth fight. Angel Lopez, unfortunately, continuing that losing streak. Hopefully he'll be back later and can reverse that. Richard Howe, though, a new man. Two-fight winning streak on cloud nine. All smiles. So happy. This is what boxing is all about. I think he's crying on the ring right now, ladies and gentlemen. Like, this is what it's about. Guys spend their whole lives training, whole lives working, blood, sweat, and tears, damage to their bodies, just for that moment where their hand is raised, that moment when they win. Remember Relatum, and this is Legacy Continues, brought to you by Red Promotions, Guerrera Promotions, and Ray Rock Entertainment. Sponsored by Patty's Q Jewelry, Estancia Mexican Cuisine, and JB Sports. Powered by Koa Combat. Pay-per-view live on Viva Live TV's Fight Night channel. Be back for the next fight. Eladio Guerrero versus Cruz Becerra. Eladio Guerrero returning back to the U.S. after his last fight in Mexico. 1-0-1 record. First fight, a very, very controversial draw. Fighting Cruz Becerra in his debut fight, professional debut fight. Cruz Becerra out of Madero, California, and Eladio Guerrero out of El Monte, California. Both guys have a lot of pride. Both guys have a lot of ego, and I'm very excited for this matchup.